Again, we'll go through the one more problems on n jobs, 3 machines. But here the processing order they have given that CAB. But here they have given the order as ABC. But the, here we have to find out the processing order as CAB. For that, what we have to do? We have to again rewrite the same table as it is here. But here we have to write the first machine C, machine A, and machine B according to the this processing order. After that, we have to find out the total elapsed time and idle time for each machine, and the next we have to find out the sequence, and again we have the some that description. Again, I will write whatever the thing is there, just I will write the here. For the machine C, what are the times we are having? That is 5, 6, 2, 3, 4, 9, 15, 11. For machine A, 4, 6, 7, 4, 5, 3, 6, 2. Okay, and for machine B, that is 8, 10, 7, 8, 11, 8, 9, and 13. Okay. We have to first, because here they are given that processing order is CAB, hence we have to rearrange the same thing once again here. After doing this one, again next we have to go for the we have to check the whether the condition is satisfying or not. That is the processing time on the first machine, least processing time on the first machine is greater than or equal to least processing time on the highest processing time on the second machine, that is machine A. Okay, or least processing time on the last machine, that is machine B, is greater than or equal to highest processing time on the machine A. That condition we have to check. First thing is, in machine C, what is the least processing time? That is 5, 6, 2, 3, 4, 9, 15, 2 minutes. That is 2. Okay, in machine C. In machine A, what is the highest processing time? That is 4, 6, 7, 4, 5, 3, 6, 2 means that is 7. Okay. Again, here least processing time is 8, 10, 7, 8, 11, 8, 9, 13 means 7 is the least processing time. Okay. Here we have to consider the first one and second one, and the second one and third one. Which condition is satisfied? Depending upon that, we have to start the problem. That is 2 is greater than or equal to 7. No, this condition is not holds good. Okay, 7 is greater than or equal to 7. Yes, that condition is holds good. Again, we have to convert this machine into two machines, that is G and H. Okay, just I will write that the G and H machines here. That is job and G, H. Okay, this is job 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And the G is, this is, we will draw the vertical lines. To write the G machine, what we have to do? We have to add the processing time on machine A. Processing time on machine C plus machine A to write the G machine. Next, to write the machine H, we have to use the machine A and machine B. Okay, this we have to add the that thing. Here 5 plus 4, 9. Okay, 6 plus 6, 12. 7 plus 2, 9. Okay, 3 plus 4, 7. 4 plus 5, 9. 9 plus 3, 12. 15 plus 6, 21. 11 plus 2, 13. Okay, that is for the G machine. Next, we have to go for the, to write the H machine. We have to add the, these two values. That is 4 plus 8, 12. Okay, 6 plus 10, 16. 7 plus 7 14, 8 plus 4 12, 5 plus 11 16, 3 plus 8 11, 9 plus 6 15, and 2 plus 13 15. Like this, we have tried the G and H. After writing this one, we have tried the sequence. What is the sequence? We have to find out by using the this thing. Okay. And here we have to identify the what is the least processing time in this table. Okay. In this table, we have set the least processing time. Okay. Least processing time. If the least processing time is on G, then we have tried that job towards left side. If the least processing time on H, then we have to jump towards right side. Okay, here the least processing time is 7. Okay, this is 9, 12, 9, 7, 9, 12, 13, 15, 15. Okay, yes, least processing time is 7. That is for the job 4. Okay, and which G machine? Hence, we have write the job 4 here first. Okay, after that, least processing time. Least processing time is 9. Yes, 9 is the least processing time. But here we are having the 3 options. Okay, this is first job, third job, and fifth job we are having. We can select anyone, there is no restriction for that one. Okay, first I will select the first one, and next I will select the third one, and next I will select the fifth one. Okay, 1, 3, 5. And in the remaining things, this is 11 is the least processing time. 11. 11 means that is on the H machine. Hence, we have to write the job 6 in the right side. Last. At the end, we have to write the job 6. After that, least processing time is that is 12. 16, 21, 15. 12 is the least processing time. Again, that is on the G machine. Hence, here we have to write the 2. Job 2. Okay, and remaining with the these two things. Here the least processing time is again 13. 13 means for the job 8, that is on the G machine. Hence we have tried the 8 here. Okay. And finally we are having the 7. Now we have got the sequence as 4, 1, 3, 5, 2, 8, 7, 6. We have tried that again in the different table. Okay. In that different table, first column is job, second column is machine C, because here the first machine is C. Okay, for that in and out we have write. For next machine is A. For again here we have write the in and out. For next machine B, we have write the in and out. Okay, first thing is by default we have to take them for machine C, starting in value as 0. Okay, and next for the fourth job, what is the processing time? That is 3. 0 plus 3, 3. Okay. Next, here we have written 3. Next, for the job 1, what is the processing time? 5. 3 plus 5, 8. Okay, again here we have written the 8. Next, for the third job, 2. 8 plus 2, 10. Okay, next for the fifth job, 4. 10 plus 4, 14. Next, for the second job, 14 plus 6. 20. Okay, next for the 8th job, 20 plus 11, 31. Okay, next for the 7th job, 31 plus 15, 46. Okay, next we have to take the 46 here. Next again for the 6th job, 9. 46 plus 9 is 55. This is for the machine C. Similarly, we have to go for the machine A. Okay. Again, here the in time is 3 because we have write this value as it is. Okay. For the job 4, machine A, processing time is 4. 3 plus 4, 7. Okay. 7 and 8. Here we have write the 8. Okay. Next one is 1. For 1, 4. 8 plus 4, 12. Okay. Next one is, here we have tried the 12. Third job means 7. 12 plus 7, 19. Okay. Next, for the fifth job, 19 here we have tried. 19 plus 5, 24. Okay. Next, for the second job, 6. 24 we have tried. 24, 6, 30. Next, here we have tried the 31. We should not write the 30 because here we are having 31. We have tried the 31. 8th job. 8th job is 2. 33. Okay. Here we have tried the 46 because the highest value is 46. 7th job. That is 6. 46 plus 6 is 52. Okay. Next, again, here we have tried the 55. For the 6th job. 3rd. 3. 55 plus 3 is 58. Okay. Next, again, we have tried the same thing for the machine B also. Okay. For the machine B, again, starting value is 7. Okay. Again, for the job 4, value is 8. 7 plus 8, 15. Here, 12, 15. We have tried 15. Next, job 1, 8. 15 plus 8, 23. Okay, next for job 3, that is 7, here we have tried the 23 plus 7 is 30, again here we have tried the 30, for job 5, 11, 30 plus 11 is 41, here again we have tried the 41, next job 2, 10, 41 plus 10, 51, here again we have tried the 51, okay, next for the job 8, 13, 15 plus 13 is 64. Okay. Next, we have tried the 64 as it is here. Okay. Next job is, that is 7. 64 plus 9. That is 73. Okay. Next, for the, here we have tried the 73. Again, for the 6th job, that is 8. 73 plus 8 is 81. Okay, here the total elapsed time is 81 units. Okay, next we have to find out the idle time for machine C. Machine C, idle time for machine A, idle time for machine B, we have to find out. To find out this one, again we have to use the this 81 as it is, 81 minus processing time of the each job, each machine, we have to calculate that one. Okay, here total processing time on the each machine is, that is 5 plus 6, 11, 12, 13, 16, 20, 29, 39, 44, 45, 55. This value is 55. Okay. Similarly for the machine A, this is 10, 17, 21, 26, 29, 35, 37. Next for the machine B, 18, 25, 33, 34, 44, 44, 52, 52, 61, 61, 64, 74. Okay, just in this value, we have to subtract the, each machine. For the first machine, we have to subtract the 55. 81 minus 55 is, that is 11 minus 5 is 6, 8 minus 6 is 2, that is 26 units. For the second machine, that is for the machine A, that is 37, okay, 11 minus 7 is 4, okay, and 8 minus 4 is 4, again 44 units for the idle time for the machine A. Next, third one, that is 74. Idle time on machine B is 11 minus 4 is 7. Okay, this is the final answer for the given problem. Okay, just I will say the total elapsed time is 81 and the idle time on machine C is 26 units and my machine A is 44 units and machine B is 7 units. This completes the problem. Thank you.